heart inflammation, called either myocarditis or pericarditis, has been occurring very rarely after vaccination with either the Pfizer vaccine or the Moderna vaccine, but seems to be more common in adolescents and young folks, especially males. Post-marketing surveillance has suggested that this myocarditis, although rare, and pericarditis rare, seems to occur more frequently with the Moderna vaccine as opposed to the Pfizer vaccine. Generally, heart inflammation would occur in the first few days to a week after vaccination, and almost all cases are actually after the second vaccine. And so patients present with chest pain, shortness of breath, and palpitations, or their heart fluttering or palpitating in their chest. And so if any of those symptoms were to occur, especially in the first few weeks after vaccination, we would suggest seeking medical attention, and probably the best option would be go to the emergency room. In the emergency room, they would generally do tests like an EKG, like some blood work, looking for heart muscle inflammation, a chest x-ray looking for causes of the shortness of breath. And the vast majority of people we've seen in our emergency room who are presenting with these sorts of symptoms have a benign workup and actually end up going home. If you're diagnosed with myocarditis or pericarditis, you often may stay in hospital for a day or two just to get a few investigations. As I mentioned, most of these investigations are benign and very reassuring. And most patients do not need treatment. This is self-limited and gets better on its own. If the inflammation is around the lining of the heart and there's chest pain associated with it, we may use simple treatments like ibuprofen or other anti-inflammatories, but otherwise this generally gets better on its own. The vast majority of these patients who have heart muscle inflammation have little to no heart muscle damage. And even if there is heart muscle damage, it generally resolves. Cases generally last days at most, resolve on their own, have very little medium and long-term negative consequences. And all international guidance has been that the rare case of myocarditis, most are mild, and getting the vaccine, the benefits far outweigh the very rare risk of myocarditis. Myocarditis or pericarditis associated with the vaccine is exceedingly rare, and you are likely more apt to get myocarditis or pericarditis if you actually get COVID. So not only are you getting COVID, but you're also getting myocarditis or pericarditis related to the COVID virus itself. And so you're kind of getting hit twice. Not only are you getting COVID, but you're just as apt or more apt to get myocarditis or pericarditis related to the COVID itself. And so the risks of getting vaccine-induced myocarditis are very, very, very small. And we feel that the benefits of getting the vaccine are far, far more important than the risks of myocarditis.